Yo, what up? Your boy Wiz Khalifa, man. Shout out Nicki Z. Yo, what up? Your boy Wiz Khalifa, man. Shout out Nicki Z and DNZ TV. Get up.
Yeah, you know what it is. Everything I do, y'all, I do it big. Yeah, screaming that's nothing. When I pulled off the lot, that's nothing. Rep in my town, when you see me, you know everything.
Black and yellow, black and yellow, black and yellow, black and yellow.
I put it down from the whip to my diamonds. I'm in
black and yellow, black and yellow, black and yellow. So damn fine. I don't like
video.
Scared of it, but them pros ain't. Soon as I hit the club, I get the move.
Mics are hot.
It's Hot Now 37, hotnow37.com, Buck and Nance. Your hot morning crew in the studio. Well, outside the studio, Nancy.
Here we are.
We are broadcasting live. We got hold of the conference room. We had to do it big if we're going to be my man, Wiz Khalifa.
Take it over.
Hey, what's up?
What's happening?
Hey.
Nice seeing you again. We saw
nice seeing you guys, too. Grammy weekend, right?
Yeah. It was a lot of fun.
It was fun. I was busy.
You were busy.
Hopping tables and stuff.
Doing stuff.
You know something? And out of all the people that went there, right, you stayed for everybody. You talked to everybody.
Yeah.
You don't do that. Like, we've been there for years, and they'll talk to certain tables. You
for
made
real?
A point to talk to everybody. Yeah.
Nah, that was my first one, you know what I'm saying? And everything that I do, I kind of try to do it how I do it. So,
well, one thing
me.
I was telling the audience who's watching you right now.
What's up, audience?
That when you came into the radio room, there was an herbal essence that followed you.
Yeah.
It was a pungent herbal essence. It was nice, though.
I was in the woods before I came.
Is that what you were? Being an herbologist that you are.
Yeah, I was, you know. Planting.
Very nice.
Checking on my trees.
Which you do very well, right?
I mean, I name them. You know, I go out in the wilderness and I name trees.
That's amazing.
So I had to go check on them, my babies.
Do you go out planting every day?
As much as possible.
Okay.
You know, gardening, it relaxes the mind.
I was going to ask you, does it help you do interviews? You know, stuff like this with people you don't really know?
I don't even know because I've never did it without gardening.
What are some of the names of the plants?
Well, I got my OG. You know, it's been around for a minute.
Okay.
That's why I call it the OG.
Okay.
It's the oldest of the plants.
Okay.
You
know,
is that the most pungent of the plants?
That's my favorite plant.
It is your favorite.
Yeah.
Nice.
I got one that's got a bad attitude. I named him Sour.
Sour.
Sour. People like that.
Yeah, with the sour individuals. I mean, you know, they're cool too, though.
You know, in a pinch, it'll do.
You gotta switch it out sometimes, you know, depending on where you're at.
Right. If you keep the same, it's never going to get you the same. You know. We appreciate you being here.
No, I appreciate y'all having me.
Congratulations, you got like 9.7 million hits on YouTube for Black and Yellow Remix. That's crazy.
Yeah, that's wild. That's wild. I don't even get to check the numbers no more because like I be moving so fast, and then when I like put up my day to days and stuff like that, I just let them go now. But they get a lot of views these days.
Especially like when with Snoop.
Uh huh.
That one's crazy.
Shout out to Snoop. Shout out to T-Pain, Juicy J. That's my man.
Okay, so the yellow Lamborghini in the videos, that's not really T-Pain's, is it?
That's mine.
That's yours?
That's yours?
Come on, man.
Yeah, no, I'm just playing.
It's too easy, man. Fool you guys.
It is really easy. I'm very gullible. But the yellow, man, that was so nice.
Yeah, it was cool. It was tight. stuff like that for video.
Man, it's random.
I don't know if it was random. It might have been like some rich guy who was there. He's like, yeah, it's the Lambo.
Use it.
Have you spent any money on something big like that, like a Lamborghini? Or...
Nah, not yet.
No.
I've been really working. I've been putting like a lot of money into my studio and stuff like that. But I think like when I chill out, you know what I'm saying? When I get a chance to like calm down and spend a month where I can actually drive it,
right.
I might do something sick.
What's the biggest thing you've bought since you've gotten so big?
I think it's my studio.
Really?
Yeah. Because I like to put a lot of money into my work so I can get it back, you know? So, like, I got a fully functioning studio in my house,
nice.
And I got one that I take on the road with me as well, on my bus, so I stay busy.
You're a really busy cat. Like, did you just get out of the studio with Chris Brown? Were you in with Chris
Brown?
Yeah,
I was in with Chris Brown when I was in L.A. I just finished up my album. I was in the studio in New York when I just, like, right before I came here. Like, my album's done, my mixtapes are done, but
nice.
I'm still recording stuff.
And aren't you doing a project with Snoop?
Yeah.
A big one, right?
Yeah, that's pretty much done.
It is done.
Yeah, we're doing a movie. And we got the soundtrack as well, but
high school.
Yeah, high school. I just seen Snoop. He was in WVU, and then he came to Pittsburgh as well. So you know, that's my homie, man. Like we getting it in, and there's so much like work being done. It's like it's crazy. It's fun too, though. You know.
And there's no competition really, cause you guys have the same kind of swag.
Yeah.
You and Snoop.
Yeah, and Snoop's like still tight. You know what I'm saying? Like he's really, 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 really good.
Yeah, he is.
So like.
we were talking about a super combo group of all like of guys.
The Stoners?
Huh?
Yeah.
So we said, okay, you, it'll be Redman,
mm-hmm.
Snoop Dogg,
uh-huh.
my man from Cypress Hill.
DJ Muggs or
the rapper. Who else
will
be
also
being there?
Be real.
Be real.
Yeah.
And who else? It'll be the highest room, the highest.
Devin the Dude.
Devin the Dude will be one. You smoke a lot?
Man, what?
And Currency will have to be in.
Currency too?
Yeah, Currency is
they need to throw Junior gone.
Currency is the man.
Yeah, are your friend? Your guys
so,
are really
that's
good.
That's my homie. That's my bro, man. Like,
so that'll be a crazy cypher right there. I know a few cats from Hoffa that could join that too. That,
yeah. I mean, anybody who wants to get down.
Anybody in this room that can hang with him with that?
Yeah. So your hair's getting ready.
I'm just growing it out. I'm never going to cut it.
You're never going to cut it?
Mm-hmm. No.
What made you decide to like grow the hair and never cut it?
I just felt like that was the thing for me to do. Hmm. You know, I woke up one day, I was like, I'm not gonna cut this. And then I just started doing it. And then people was like, yo, man, what's going on? And I was like, F you.
I told you he was gonna solve it up, right?
It was just the F.
I understand. We appreciate that.
Yeah, because when it comes to my hair, I get real defensive, man. Not against you, you know.
It's gonna be
no, but I mean, I think that, you know, the hair is kind of like a definitive thing.
Yeah, man. It's
you know?
Like you gotta stand up for it.
Right.
People gotta know they can't mess with the hair.
Right. I appreciate that.
No, I'm not gonna dread it.
You got the Kwame thing there, too.
Yeah, a little patch in front. It's real wrong, but like, I'm black, so it shrinks up. You
wow.
know what I'm saying? But like, my hair is like, I don't have freaking hair. And then it's going to be down here, and then it's going to be like...
So you're going to braid it, or what are you going to do with it?
I'm
going
to do anything. I'm going to be like Palomalu, you know?
Can't even get the helmet off.
Oh my
we got Wiz Khalifa in the studio, yes, record right now, the big record, Black and Yellow. Let's talk about that record.
Yeah.
Now, you've been recording and putting music on for a long time.
Mm-hmm.
Was that record meant to catch, or was it just something that radio found and said, okay, let's grab this one? Because you put a lot of stuff out before.
Yeah. I definitely, like, focused on that one, like, really, like, had to catch on. Like, when I recorded it, we were in a point with Atlantic where it was like, yo, we need a single, we need a
right.
look.
Yeah, that one.
And I was recording a bunch of songs, and you know, when you're with labels, kind of, you gotta give it to them instead of them picking it, you know? I mean, you know, they kind of, not saying that anybody individually, but sometimes they don't know exactly what they want until they have it in their hands. So when I recorded Black and Yellow, I was really, really confident in it. I was like, yo, this is my single. It was like, I record a couple more songs. I liked them, but I was like, yo, this is my single. I did what y'all asked me to do. I want this one, so let's go with this one. And then they played it, you know, for the people in the building. They were like, all right, cool, let's do it. And then they put their energy behind it. They worked it fully.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And they really trusted me, and I trusted them, and here we are.
Rolling Papers comes out when? March 20?
March 29th.
29th. Yeah. You excited about it?
Yeah, I'm super excited.
Nervous or are you?
No, I'm not nervous. I'm just real happy that people get this music. You know what I'm
yeah,
saying?
Yeah.
Like, I know what's on there because I've been able to listen to it, so I want everybody else to be able to hear it too.
Is there a favorite song that you have? Or is it hard to really say that? I know they're all your babies.
Yeah.
I know that's how artists always feel about it.
I got a couple favorites on there. One of them, it's called The Race. It's a really, really, really good song.
Is it just you?
Yeah, it's just me on there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, just rapping and singing and laughing and stuff.
That's what I was saying earlier today, that your laugh is wicked and infectious. I don't know what it is, but it is, isn't it? Like, if you start laughing,
no,
like, you just want to laugh.
I was on YouTube, I seen, like, a video of, like, 3 minutes of just my laugh.
But that
is funny. You can write it down, EJ.
It's kind of like, that's wild, yo.
Because you seem like a happy cat.
I'm super happy. Who wouldn't be happy to be here?
Right. I mean, you're in a good position right now.
Yeah, if you're sad, then you're just...
There's no reason, right?
New album coming out, but you're still making the mix CDs and everything. What's the difference? How much effort do you put into the new album's going to hit the streets and retail stores?
Uh-huh, March 29th.
Mixed CDs.
Yeah.
Now, what's the difference? Because you just make them for the streets. What's...
Like, my mixtapes, they're just more free. You know what I'm saying? Like, as far as my attitude, as far as my beat picking, you don't got to worry about samples or anything. So, like... I could be in the Apple store and hear a song, you know what I'm saying? Be like, yo, flip that beat, and then make it, and then do a song over it and put it right out, you know, for a mixtape.
Right.
Whereas for the album, I really got to focus on it. I like to go on with my producers, make some stuff from scratch, you know what I'm saying? I really like focus on what I'm talking about as well. Every song has to mean something to really bring that together, whereas the mixtapes are more just loose, you know?
Right now, we're going to get into Black and Yellow with Wiz Khalifa in the studio right now. Hot 937.com. We're here live with a bunch of people. Y'all make some noise out there. Black and Yellow on Hot 937.